Hey, hi everyone, Daryl here. What I'm going to do, right, I'm going to guide you guys on how to validate and upload an XBRL file. Okay, when do you need to file your financial statements using XBRL format? When the company does not have an exempt status. So generally, right, in most cases, it will be when the shareholder includes a corporation. So if there's a non-natural person in the company shareholding structure, then you would have to prepare the files in XBRL, or if the shareholders are like more than 20, then you have to prepare your company financial statements in XBRL. And if you don't prepare your financial statements in XBRL, right, then you can't do your annual return filing. So where you need to go, right, is to you need to go to bizfinex.gov.sg, bizfinex.gov.sg. Then I've already logged in using my Corp Pass. So what you need to do is that you need to go to this tab called Validate and Upload. So when you click Validate and Upload, so for here, right, my email address already pre-filled in already, because this is the one where they see the default one that I've given to Accra. So I've been uploading and everything from my profile already. So this XBRL files, right, all I need to do is to add the XBRL files. So when you go in, right, you go to the folder, then there are many files. So what you need to do is just double click on the file that can be uploaded. It's actually a zip file, so when you do up your XBRL file, right, and you're done with it, then when you want to export and you complete your XBRL, then you will get this zip file. So you need this zip file and you upload, and then you click validate and upload. Then it will go through a validation status where it will show processing. It can take some time, and you can validate and upload multiple files at the same go. So you don't have to wait. So if let's say like if you are doing your XBRL for maybe four companies, maybe you guys are a corporation, like a holding company, then you want to prepare and upload your XBRL files all at one go for four companies, then you do it all at one shot. So now you can see validation status. There's this thing called possible errors. So I click the possible errors, and it will open up another window. So what I need to do is that I need to click on all these boxes. Then I go all the way down to the bottom. Then right, I click proceed. So possible errors acknowledged successfully. Your XBRL file has been uploaded. And then you click OK. So once I do this, everything is done. When I go into my bizfile.gov.sg and I file my annual return, I can see the XBRL file inside the portal. So when I click file using XBRL financial statements, you will see this file there. Okay, so that's all. And we'll see you in the next video.